How worried is Angela Merkel at this point?
Well, she was certainly going for a batting for Sarkozy. I mean, she even suggested right at the start of his campaigning that she helped campaign with him, because obviously the two of them, Merkozy as they've been dubbed, have really been key. Their alliance has been absolutely vital in sort of steering Europe through its most difficult economic crisis over the last couple of years, constructing this fiscal pact, which now 25 of the 27 member states have agreed to, which is now in the process of being ratified, which François Hollande says that he wants to renegotiate. Now, that for Angela Merkel is sort of her worst nightmare. That brings you back to square one. She's also said through her government spokesman in a press conference this morning that she considers the rise of the far right in the elections extremely alarming, but that she expects that to be sort of ironed out in the second round. But I mean, you know, we have heard from François Hollande that he is going to be taking in Europe in a different direction. If he does assume the presidency, it's going to be in a direction of growth, of more employment, and against really what Angela Merkel wants, which is the sort of austerity path. But there is no doubt that he is as well aware as she is that that Franco-German alliance runs deeper than these kinds of election results, that it is absolutely vital that they cooperate. And even if Angela Merkel did want Sarkozy to win this election, which he still might, that alliance is key. She's a pragmatist. She will make it work, whoever comes out on top.
I just want to, I guess, ask you quickly, you just touched upon this, Diana. So what would then, an Hollande presidency mean for the EU's plans to get budgets in order?
Well, he wants to renegotiate the fiscal pact, first of all. He thinks it's too much about cutting deficits, cutting debts, that it's far too austere, that countries in the south of Europe who are in recession as it is, and countries like France, which are in severe economic problems, don't need more austerity to get them out of recession. They need more spending. So he's advocating bigger public spending in France, boosting the public sector, which sort of is an anathema to Germany. He's also been talking about more intervention from the European Central Bank to directly help governments through this debt crisis. He's been talking about a joint euro bond. These are all things that Germany has struggled not to allow in its policy making in Europe. So, you know, there are going to be tough times ahead. It will be a step back in terms of the kind of policies that have been constructed for Europe. But François Hollande is not alone in advocating greater growth. You know, that's the kind of thing we've been hearing from the Italian premier, Mario Monti, for some time, from Spain as well, from Portugal. So he does have allies. And what he's been saying is that Germany can't be just an island doing well whilst the rest of Europe flounders, Monita.